Now we're going to look at the other result of max quant. So we've looked at the PTXQC report. We've looked at the peptide assignments. Now we're going to look at the protein group assignments. One of the first things you should notice is that there are many more peptide lines than protein lines. And this makes sense because several peptides will map to each protein. So we're going to start by going to our history. And downloading the max quant groups, you can click the save icon to download, and then uploading that data to Posit Cloud. So I've already uploaded this. You can see Galaxy 3 max quant protein groups for data 1 and 2. With a file with a long name like this, we have two choices. We can either click the checkbox here and rename it to something simpler, like proteins.tabular, or we can be really careful when we're writing our script to not type the name and let R do it for us. So I'm just gonna remind you guys how to do that. When we have a command like read.table, we have to specify the file name in quotes. If we put the quotes and start typing the name, we can then hit tab to complete the name. That works just as well as renaming it, so that's what I chose to do. So I've already done steps 1, 2, and 3. I've downloaded the file, uploaded the file, and now I'm ready to run this line to read in the file. One of the first things I want to check is the size. So if something went wrong, as I read in the file, we end up with a different size file. So I can look at this. It looks like it read in okay, right? The headers are headers. They're not data. And it says 2336. So I go back to Galaxy and look. It's 2,337 lines. With a header, that's exactly what I got on Posit Cloud. So I know that I read in all of the data and nothing went wrong with that read.table command. One important thing with this file is it's tab delimited. So I did have to say separate, the separator is a tab and that the header was true. So if those weren't there, that number won't match what you expect and you'll need to make sure that you have, you're reading it incorrectly. The next thing I wanna do is I wanna get rid of the rows that start C-O-N underscore underscore. All of those are things that the software thinks are contaminants. I don't really care about differences in abundance for proteins that are not of research interest. So I'm going to remove all the rows that have contaminants and also all the rows that have decoys. So you watched the video on how MaxQuant works, how it creates target decoy sequences by just reversing the amino acids. So all of those REV codes are also things that aren't relevant to research. Now that I have a cleaned up list, and you can see it's smaller, right? It's only 2,225 as opposed to 2,336. I'm ready to look for the top proteins. So what are the most abundant proteins in this sample? And when I run this, I get 11 proteins. And that's because when you use the deplier tool to find the top 10, the proteins that you find can have a tie. So if we sort this by number, you can see there are two proteins. So number 10 and number 11, both have 37 peptides and deplier won't make a choice for you. It's gonna include both in your list. So I ran top 10, I get top 11, but we look at the counts, it makes a lot of sense. My top protein is a human DNA dependent protein kinase. So that's the one that had the highest level, and then two types of filamin are second and third. So now I know what the proteins are, and I have in my code comments, I get 11 proteins because the last two have 37, and I'm ready to write this to a file that I could email to someone who didn't use R, that I could share with anyone, or that I, you know, could even go into a PowerPoint presentation. So if I was creating a poster for my senior thesis, I might want to write to a CSV file just to start making that table and formatting the table. So once you have that list, you can go back to the assignment. What you're gonna turn in is that list. You're gonna upload that file to submit. Let me know if you have any questions and good luck sifting through your MaxQuant data and discovering what proteins were most expressed in these HeLa cells.